And welcome to another edition of A Shave and a Song, a weekly program dedicated to shaving with a straight razor, as well as listening to some great music while we do it. So today, I'll be shaving with my Dovo Best Quality 6/8 with customized scales. I carved these myself, fashioned myself out of some zebra wood. Let's see, for the shaving soap today, good old Tabac. And I don't have the fancy ceramic soap holder, so I just put it in a little crock that I have. And love Tabac. And we're going to finish it off with some Tabac aftershave as well. And then, obviously, once we're all done, good old Clubman Pinuad. So we're in for a really good shave today. I'm looking forward to it. I hope you all are doing well today. Let's just jump right to it, shall we? So, I love documentaries. Always have. I think that probably dates back to, this is going to tell you how old I am. My dad and I used to watch a program in the, early 70s, I think it was, called Mutual of Omaha's Wild Kingdom. It was kind of National Geographic days. You know, now that we have the National Geographic Channel on the satellite or cable or whatever it is. Well, this was before that. It was like a weekly program came on, and it's probably hilarious if I'd ever go back and watch it by today's standard, but I enjoyed watching with my dad, and that kind of got me hooked on documentaries. And so I watch documentaries quite often. I find them very engaging and entertaining. And a few years ago, I came across a documentary that was produced and directed by Foo Fighters' Dave Grohl, and it's called Sound City. And it is a documentary that tells the story of Sound City Studios located in Los Angeles, and particularly about a soundboard, an analog soundboard that was used there to record a lot of artists. It was a soundboard that Dave Grohl would eventually go on to acquire once the studio shut its doors. Takes just a little bit to get what I need here, because I always, with Tabac, I always have to just find the right water consistency. It's got some good old tallow in it. But once it goes, it goes. So I think I've got it pretty good now. I think so. So we'll build it up in the scuttle a little bit. So anyway, this is about, it's a documentary about an analog recording studio. Analog, not digital, analog. And this particular recording studio had one of four analog consoles that existed anywhere in the world, and there was something special both about the studio and that analog mixer, that console, as many of the artists who recorded there tell about in this documentary. And there's a lot of great artists that are featured in this documentary. I'm going to wet my face. And let's apply good old Tabac, shall we? If you haven't tried Tabac, you have to. I was a little scared about trying Tabac because of all the mixed reviews. If you've ever watched some of my shows in the past, people said that it smelled too perfumey. And I was a little afraid to try it. And you know what? I am so glad I did, because it's one of my favorites. Get a great shave with it every time. But anyway, okay, so some of the artists that recorded at Sound City Studios are artists like Paul McCartney, Tom Petty, Trent Reznor, Fleetwood Mac, Nirvana, Rick Springfield. This is who I'm featuring today, Rick Springfield. Now, I enjoyed Rick Springfield back in the 80s. I'll admit I liked what he was doing. Now I know a lot of good old hardcore rockers didn't like Rick Springfield. You know, mainly the people that were attracted to Rick tended to be of the female persuasion and young. Let's start the first pass, shall we? But I always enjoyed listening to Rick Springfield. I appreciated his talent and what he could do. And I even went to see Rick Springfield in concert in the 80s. And let me tell you, the guy can put on a show. Whether you like him or not, you know, a lot of people kind of lump that in with maybe Michael Jackson as well. A lot of people didn't like Michael Jackson, but he was talented. He could put on a show. Rick Springfield, I don't care if you like him or not. The guy has talent, and he was able to put on a show. Probably still is. So, here's the part I need to stop talking on. It's always this one side that gives me a little washboarding. I don't know why that is. But as part of the documentary, Dave Grohl invited some of the artists who recorded there in the past to come back to his studio, his personal studio, because he purchased the console and moved it on into his home studio. But he invited some of the artists to come back and record brand new material, something that that was new and hadn't been released before. And Rick Springfield was one of the artists invited. And this recording would turn out to be the soundtrack for the documentary. A soundtrack called Sound City Reel to Reel. So Rick Springfield and Dave Grohl and some others, they got together and they wrote a song that we're featuring today called The Man That Never Was. And I chose this song today, you know, because you have an idea. If you grew up with Rick Springfield in the 80s, you might have a preconceived idea of what his sound is like, what his genre is. But The Man That Never Was really showcases Rick Springfield's ability to just rock, just let it all go. It is a great song on a great album as part of a soundtrack to a great documentary. Sound City. I recommend that you look it up either on Netflix, YouTube, Hulu, whatever. Find Sound City, watch the documentary, and then sit back and let's listen to a song featuring Rick Springfield from that soundtrack. 2013 is its release, so it's not all that old. And it features Rick Springfield really showcasing his ability to just rock it out. This is The Man That Never Was. We'll be right back. telling you, that is a song you just can't help but want to sing along with. Great tune. And it really showcases, I think, Rick Springfield's talent. I'm not saying that what he did in the 80s does not. I'm just saying that anybody who hung their hat on Rick Springfield being like a chick performer, I'm sorry for that word, woman performer, whatever. We used a lot of language back in the 80s that you can't use today or shouldn't use, I guess. And I'm still trying to get out of the habit. But anyway, anybody ever accused Rick Springfield of, you know, just cranking out tunes for the ladies? That argument, I think, goes out the window with this song. It's a great rock piece. Shows off his ability to play guitar, to sing, and to, again, crank out a tune that you just want to sing to. Love that tune. Love the piece. Hope you did too. And I hope you'll check out the documentary. There are several songs from that documentary that I really want to feature on this show, and I don't know if I should feature them back to back. You know, now that I've kind of started with one, if the next couple of weeks I should go ahead and feature some of the other songs from it, or if I should just wait. I don't know. Let me know what you think in the comments. If you want to hear more from that documentary, or if you want me to space them out a little bit. Let me know what you think in the comments anyway. Make sure you hit the like button and subscribe so you can be up to date on when new shows come out. Try to do them once a week. If you've got an artist you want to recommend, put it in the comment section. I'll give a listen. Always love being introduced to new pieces of music. Even if it's revisiting artists like we did today. And I've kind of started my shameless... I fully admit it's a shameless request, but you know, if I'm ever so humbled to have Rick Springfield or even Dave Grohl watch this particular show, and they happen to be ever performing in the Chicago area, I will trade either one of you one of my coveted shaving shirts, like the one I'm wearing today. This one says Colorado 14ers, and I have climbed several. I would part with one of my coveted shaving t-shirts just to come hear you guys. Just some tickets. Isn't that terrible? But in all seriousness, check out the soundtrack. Oh, it's fantastic. Absolutely fantastic. And it's digital recorded, too. Or not digital, analog recorded, too. It's one of my favorite documentaries. All right. That does it. Got a great shave today, good using Tabac. I want to show you about cleaning my razors. I don't you always see me do something every week down below. You can't see me cleaning my straight razor, but I do it every week. Take a little bit of alcohol, put it on a cotton cotton ball. And then I just kind of very lightly go over the blade just a little bit. And that's a couple of reasons I do that. One, to get any shaving scum, soap scum off of it. And two, that if there's any water on it, I want to help dry it out so it dries really well. And then when I'm done, after I clean everything up, I will strop it 10 times, once on the cloth and once on the leather, before I put it away. So we are at that point where it's time to put on, well, I gotta clean the face off, I guess. Can't leave the soap on there. There we go. Now we can apply the aftershave. Good old Tabac. Nervous about initially trying it. Turns out one of my absolute all-time favorites. Good old Tabac. And I like a liberal helping of this when I put it on. There we go. Oh. Just massage it in. Enjoy it. All right, so I hope you enjoyed the show today. I don't know why I did that. So enjoy the show today, and I hope you did enjoy the show today. Enjoy your day today. Check out Reel to Reel, or Sound City Reel to Reel 2013 is the soundtrack release. Check out Sound City documentary, and check out Rick Springfield again. You know, come on, he's not just an 80s guy. He's doing some stuff that really kicks some rear end, and it's good stuff. Good old rock and roll. So, thanks, Rick, if I can call you Rick. I like the stuff. I like the sound. So, thanks for that, and everyone, until next time, live life, and happy shaving.